Any future requests or any future discussion will of course always be considered on its merits, Ms. Payne told reporters in Sydney. She did not discuss potential future strikes with Secretary Mattis on Saturday, she said. LoadingMs Payne said the strikes were not seeking to escalate the conflict in Syria, but the AFP news agency reported that Iran, a supporter of the Syrian regime, immediately warned of regional consequences, and global eyes have turned to how Russian leader Vladimir Putin will respond. NSW Liberal Senator Jim Mullen, a former Australian Army Major General, said the strikes were the right thing to do without a doubt, but he hoped their reaction could be controlled. I don't think Mr. Putin has a lot of options, Senator Mullen told Fairfax Media. His options are as limited as the American actions are. Everyone's talking a big game, but the options are very limited and very dangerous, Senator Mullen said. There was absolutely no reason and no justification for Australia to participate in any future airstrikes of the kind threatened by Mr. Trump on Saturday. Putting Prime Minister Malcolm Turnbull, who spoke to his British counterpart Theresa May on Saturday, shamed Russia for its blatant disregard of international law in using its veto power at the United Nations Security Council to block an independent investigative body to look at chemical weapons used by the Syrian regime. Mr. Turnbull praised the US, Britain and France for acting forcefully to what he described as the illegal and utterly reprehensible actions of Syrian leader Bashar al-Assad. The Labour opposition broadly agreed with the government's stance, with Mr. Shorten describing the U.S. action as appropriate, but Greens leader Richard Di Natale condemned the barrage of missiles as a dangerous move from an untrustworthy U.S. president that would escalate the complex situation in Syria. Ms. Payne said the targeted strikes on three sites, a research center near Damascus, a weapons storage facility west of Homs and a nearby command post, had reduced the regime's chemical weapons capability while minimizing the risk to civilians. The strike was calibrated, proportionate and targeted, she said. It sends a clear and strong message that the use of chemical weapons will not be tolerated by the international community. These violations of international laws and norms cannot be allowed to continue.